Back in February, at the beginning of Lent, my former classmate and I, we were discussing ways to keep ourselves motivated on our goals. He had just quit smoking. He only wanted to quit smoking for Lent, actually. And I told him, well, can we come back to this at the end of Lent and see how you feel about this? And I made sure to check in with him the day before Lent ended. I worried for him, actually, and I asked him how he was feeling, and at first he didn't feel as good as he thought he did, but then we talked about what happened during Lent. And the unfortunate thing was I could only talk to him online at this point. That was kind of unfortunate. At the beginning I was hoping to check in with him in person, but obviously the year had other plans on us. And so at the beginning of Lent, he had quit smoking. And I had started intermittent fasting, and I went on a fast at the beginning of Lent. I told everybody I was going to go on a 40-day fast. I knew that wasn't going to happen. Most people probably knew it wasn't going to happen, but I called it a 40-day fast because I wanted to fast as long as I could until I couldn't safely do it anymore. I think I ended up doing a little bit over 2 days. But my former classmate and I, we were discussing ways to keep ourselves motivated. And I was telling him about how much money he could save by not smoking. I think we calculated it was enough to take a pretty decent vacation. And I suggested to him that he should go to Gdansk Bay. But my former classmate was actually more motivated by the fact that he had to go outside to smoke. And, you know, this was the beginning of February we were talking about. And he didn't want to go outside in the shivering cold, which was why I worried for him. Because at the end of Lent, that wouldn't apply nearly as much. That's why I wanted to check in with him as we were nearing Lent, the end of Lent. But then, a couple months later, he had another reason for wanting to avoid going out and into the hallways of his apartment building, obviously. So that turned out very well, too. But for me, it was the money. And I remember as I was telling him, I suggested to my former classmate to take the $2,000 or $3,000 he was spending on cigarettes every year and to go to Gdansk Bay instead. This was back when you could actually go to Gdansk Bay, unlike right now. I'm recording this on October 22nd, 2020. But as I said it to him, I realized that I spend even more money on food than he does on cigarettes. Obviously, I can't give it up completely, but I was spending 2 or 3 trips to Gdansk Bay on my food every year. And I realized that I could at least cut that back quite a bit, right? But my classmate was more worried about going out in the shivering cold. And now that I think about it, it kind of makes sense. I used to spend a lot of time thinking about preparing, getting, buying what I need to eat, cooking it, cleaning up after I was eating. And also, come to think about it, I used to have a lot more bowel movements, and obviously that can be time consuming. And especially if you're traveling on the road a lot like I am right now, not having to worry about your bowels half as often is just really convenient, especially if you're on the road and you don't necessarily have a place to wash up, and sometimes your body might even stink from what you're eating. I find that to be the biggest benefit, that my body is a lot more low maintenance now that I'm not constantly putting stuff into it. I find that to be a big benefit. Anyway, so we both save a lot of time and money, which makes me wonder, what do you waste your time and money on?